Just a brief word about right hand and left hand. Now, a lot of right hand technique is really from the wrist rather than from the arm. If you play with your whole arm, you're going to get something that sounds very stiff. So the movement is mostly from the wrist and just a little bit from the arm. It's strumming like this. Basic position for the left hand is it's kind of around there. Classical players tend to keep their thumb right over on the back of the fingerboard, but most jazz and rock players keep the thumb around here and even use it on chords sometimes. So that's the basic position. It's very relaxed and very comfortable.
This is the plectrum I've been using for the past 2 years. It's hard, heavy. I'm not playing it that way for a start, which most probably people, you know, do when they start playing the guitar. But if you use this part of the plectrum, especially if it has got something like that on it, like something like that, it gives you like a kind of...
The reason I use a heavy pick is because it's more like an extension of your fingers for me when playing live.
So if I play something like... So it's up and down. I know that, well, somebody told me that, a producer told me that many people can't do that because they have to go like... which is much, much harder. But unfortunately, they can't do it up and down, which gives you the speed if you need it.
Flat picking, that's playing with the right hand holding onto the flat pick, like this. What I tend to do most of the time is to combine flat picking and finger picking. Now, we've heard some flat picking, let's look at finger picking. That's using thumb and two fingers usually, sometimes three fingers. You can play either with your bare fingers, or you can use these things called finger picks, which slip over your fingers. These give you a harder sound and perhaps a more mechanical sound. Anyway, I'm gonna do this without. The thumb is used for the bass pattern and the fingers play accompaniment or a melody on top. So in this exercise, we're gonna have this pattern on the bass. Now, what I tend to do when I'm using my fingers, is hold the flat pick at the same time. So you can combine the two techniques. Let's try holding the pick and using the second and third fingers as well. And what we're going to do is play notes in groups of three, and we're going to pick them together like that. More like the way a keyboard player would play his instrument, playing the notes all at the same time. So you can get something like this. This has a lot of applications in other ways. Another thing you can do with finger picking is syncopation. So if you set up a bass rhythm and then put a syncopation on top, like that. We'll be right back. let's look at right hand tricks. A popular effect for the right hand is the tremolo arm. I've got one on here.
Look at this. The bridge, you see, here. What you're doing is literally raising the pitch of the strings by pulling up and lowering it by pushing down. So if you use it together, like a up and down, you get that effect.
Damping is a very common trick on the guitar. It's used a great deal, and someone like Michael uses it to great effect.
Well, what I'm doing is I put my, whatever this part is called, I put that on the strings as, if you do it too much, it goes like, if you don't do it at all, it goes like that. If you just put it in the right position, it goes like. You hear a clean sound, I'm taking it off.
You see, I'm dampening there, and I'm being careful not to hit any of the other strings on the guitar. So you don't want to touch any other strings apart from the three strings that you're immediately dealing with. That's your E and your A and your D strings here. If I was not bearing the dampening and not hitting the other strings in mind, it'll get this kind of effect going. You know, and then it's sort of wrong.
Another trick for the right hand is the picked harmonic. Now, the important thing in this is to keep the right hand exactly one octave above the left hand, exactly 12 frets above. I know two techniques for this. One technique involves holding the pick very near to the end, and you strike the string first with the pick and then with the flesh of your thumb, like this. This is over the 12th fret. Has to be half the string length. So you get this kind of. The other way to achieve this technique is to use the end of your first finger. Say we take an E down here on the fourth string. Now you position your first finger over the 14th fret there, exactly 12 frets above the note that you're playing. Now you hold this very still, then you pick with the right hand. So you can do a piece like a.